Hello friends, today we will discuss about principles of pattern making. To know the principles of pattern making, to understand the drafting and flat pattern techniques, to comprehend the draping method of pattern making, to understand methods of taking body measurements for various garments. Garment construction is an art and industry by the virtue of which garments are fitted on every type of the body comprising of 364 bones. It involves making of suitable garment for an individual. The garment construction involves study and analysis of the garment to be made in terms of taking of measurements, drafting of the pattern, the cutting of the garment according to the pattern, the joining of different parts, the fitting and necessary alterations, the sewing and finishing of the garment, the application of trimmings if these are used, the pressing methods. Pattern making is a highly skilled technique which calls for technical ability and sensitivity to interpret a design with a practical understanding of garment construction. For successful dress designing, pattern making forms the fundamental step. This function connects design to production by producing paper templates for all components such as cloth, hemming, fusible, etc., which have to be cut for completing a specific garment. A foundation pattern, also called as block pattern, basic pattern, and master pattern, or in the trade called as a sloper, is a perfectly plain pattern which fits the individual and which conforms to present day's silhouette. A block pattern is a foundation pattern and is generally close fitting with no allowances for fullness and additional shaping and with sufficient allowances for normal movement only. It consists of five pattern pieces, that is body's front, body's back, skirt front, skirt back, and the sleeve pattern. The basic pattern should have only a minimum number of darts and seams, and it should fit the body comfortably without being tight or loose. There are three methods of preparing patterns, that is, the first one being drafting, second one flat pattern making technique, third one draping fabric on a model or the person concerned. Commercial patterns made for standard measurements using one of the above methods are also available in today's market. Coming to the first procedure, that is drafting. It is a two-dimensional basic method of preparing a paper pattern. Drafting may be defined as a system of drawing patterns on paper with mechanical precision on the basis of body measurements. The pattern is prepared on brown paper using personal measurements of the wearer. The garment prepared by this method fits exactly to the satisfaction of the wearer. It is economical to draft one's own patterns. Also, changes in style can be made adopting the basic pattern. This type of pattern can be constructed by drafting manually or produced by a computer which has been programmed to construct basic patterns according to the given measurements and proportions. This is an effective and economical method which can be learned easily, unlike draping, which requires a model, a lot of fabric, and a considerable skill. Coming to advantages of drafting, a good pattern of the right size that has been adjusted to suit individual requirements will enable customer to obtain a good fit. A pattern prepared on thick paper or cardboard can be preserved for a long time and can be used over and over again. By manipulating the basic pattern pieces, it is possible to produce patterns for complicated and original designs. For example, the basic sleeve can be adapted for a puff sleeve or a bell sleeve. A paper pattern of a particular size can be used to make new patterns or proportionately larger or smaller sizes by following a systematic procedure called as grading. Cutting with the help of a paper pattern is quicker and easier than drafting straight away on the fabric. Use of a paper pattern will help to cut the garment with a minimum amount of fabric because it is possible to try out the placement of pattern pieces in different ways till one has found the most economical way to cape them. At the same time, the drafting also has disadvantages, which include it is time consuming process as it takes lot of time to draft the patterns. Unless the technique and principles of drafting are known, it is difficult for the person to prepare paper patterns. The paper pattern can be rarely used more than once unless copied under a thicker sheet. The second technique includes flat pattern technique. The flat pattern making is the fastest and most efficient method ever devised for developing patterns. It can control the consistency of size and fit of mass produced garments. The system depends upon the patterns that has been previously developed and perfected. The patterns are called as working patterns. They are used as a base from which a variety of other pattern shapes are generated. The original working pattern is never altered but must retain in its original form to be used as a base for developing other design patterns. In this way, the original is retained as a master copy. The advantages of flat pattern method include: this method is based on the use of a simple pattern which is changed or modified by a specific direction to create a pattern for a chosen design. Flat pattern method is a technique which increases the ability to plan new procedures, organize work efficiently, analyze intelligently the cause of mistakes, and make proper corrections and practice economy in the restyling of out-of-date clothing and old patterns. This method starts with a pattern that has specific outline, definite size, and adequate amount of ease. These are all retained throughout the pattern making process. The method is very helpful for the beginners. It introduces new patterns and new designs and analyzes intelligently the cause of mistakes. It is a means of creative ability. Alterations can be easily made by dot manipulation. In this method, the curved edges of the body are considered as flat. It is most economical and not too laborious. As the drafting of patterns are based on personal measurements, the garment will fit better, especially if body measurements don't have the same proportions as that of standard sizes. Disadvantages of this method include: it is a time consuming process as it takes a lot of time to draft the flat pattern. Unless the techniques and principles of flat pattern techniques are known, it is difficult for the persons to prepare paper pattern. The basic block needs to be preserved for a long time. The basic foundation pattern needs to be altered if changes are there in body measurement. Let us look at the other technique, that is draping. Draping can be treated as one method involving a detailed survey and study of the figure to build up a reliable fitting experience for the customer. Draping originally was called as modeling. This was the original method of constructing garment patterns and is still widely used in the clothing designs houses that are in Paris. Draping is a free approach and is always to a certain extent experimental and cannot be described as a precise technique. Modeling is done in a fitting room on a dress form with a stand. Dress forms vary in size. Generally, an average size dress form of bust 88 centimeters or 92 centimeters is selected for this purpose. The designer works from a sketch or a mental picture and gives a three-dimensional form to an idea of a garment. The wrong side of the fabric is draped on the dress form or the figure. The effect of the fabric as it flows and drapes is readily visible on the dress form. Muslin cloth is used for draping. As the fabric is draped on the dress form, pin and mark the stitching line with a pencil. The muslin pattern, which is the end product of the draping, is removed from the stand and each component is copied onto the paper pattern and necessary allowances are then added to give the design effect as planned by the designer. Advantages of draping include: various styles can be tried over the model. Very simple to work once when the techniques are learnt. Disadvantages: required model or dress form to drape. It requires lot of fabric. It is a laborious process. It is not economical as fabric consumption is more. Coming to the next aspect, that is commercial patterns. Commercial patterns were first made in USA in 1850 by Ebenezer Butterick, who was a tailor. In the beginning, they were crude patterns in rough paper for simple designs only. The first patterns were for men's and boys' clothing. Commercial patterns were prepared on the basis of standard measurements. Patterns for women and children were also developed later and became available commercially. Commercial patterns are usually done on tissue paper. Since tissue paper is not bulky, it allows many pieces of pattern to be packed compactly in an envelope. In commercial patterns, seam allowances are included for safety. These patterns provide fashions in current trend designed to fit certain sizes. These patterns indicate neck sizes for garments such as shirts, chest or bust measurement for children and women. Waist, hip and length measurements for pants, trousers and skirts. Even to those with the ability and desire to design their own clothing, a commercial pattern makes a good starting point. These patterns explain the steps in using the pattern and are mostly used by dress manufacturing companies. It also gives information on suitable fabrics, quantity of material required, pattern layouts, etc. Advantages of commercial patterns include paper patterns are useful not only to the beginner but also to the expert as there is no risk of the material being wrongly cut. It is particularly useful to the beginner as it is a better method of learning than cutting the material directly. Paper patterns can be preserved and used whenever required and is therefore time and labor saving. Adjustment in paper patterns can be done to ensure perfect fitting. By using the basic paper pattern, it is possible to bring changes in the design. For example, the basic sleeves can be adapted to make puff or other styles of bell sleeves. The use of paper pattern will enable one to cut a garment with minimum amount of fabric because it is possible for the dress designer to try out the placement of pattern pieces in an economical way. Disadvantages of commercial patterns include like they are not easily available everywhere. They are available only for few selected designs. Let us see the importance of body measurements in pattern making. Measurements play a major role in the development of basic pattern set. Garment construction is only based on measurements. So, it is very important for a dressmaker to know how to take body measurements. There are two types of measurements, that is horizontal and vertical. Horizontal measurements, these are taken in width, so they are called as horizontal measurements. Examples include across shoulder, bust line, waist round, upper chest or lower chest round, thigh round, knee round, hip or seat round, ankle round, sleeve round, cuff round. Next category, that is vertical measurements, taken on width, hence they are called as vertical measurements. Top length, waist length, front neck length, back neck length, trouser length, etc. There are two different approaches to the drafting of patterns by measurements. One relies entirely upon direct measurements taken on the figure. The other method is obtaining various measurements and proportions from one or two basic measurements, mostly from the bust, sometimes checked by height. This is generally known as divisional system of drafting. The divisional system or any variation combining both the systems is used mainly in tailoring and whatever its merits, it is generally too much rigid for dressmaking, where shapes of the garments are less standardized. Fashion changes more frequently. Fashion details are more varied and subtle, and the fabrics cover a much bigger range. Indirect measurements are derived from garments of the prospective customers. Types of measurements. Basic measurements, which are essential for the construction of every pattern. The supplementary measurements are those which may be useful when working on a particular design or for a particular figure. The choice and number of letters depend on various circumferences and are influenced not only by style and fashion but also by the ideas, experience and working methods of the cutter. Basic measurements for a bodice block include bodice, sleeve, skirt. Let us see what are the measurements required for bodice. Bust measurement, hip measurement, waist measurement, back width measurement, chest width, shoulder, center back length, center front length. Then coming to the sleeve, one requires top arm measurement, length of the arm or sleeve, length of the elbow, elbow width, cap height, wrist, sleeve round, cuff details. Then for the skirt block, one requires hip round, waist round and desired length. So, if you have all these three sets of measurement, one can successfully make basic block. Success in garment construction depends on accurate measurements. Before a pattern is made or purchased, body measurements should be taken to determine the correct pattern size. These basic patterns can be used as basis for variety of styles. Body measurements are also useful to make pattern adjustments to fit one's own figure. So, let us see how to prepare for taking body measurements. All the body measurements are taken over the type of undergarments to be worn with the garments. Another person is needed to take measurements. Before taking measurements, a cord or tape is fastened around the waist and left until all measurements have been completed. The accuracy of several measurements depends on this exact waistline location. The person whose measurements are being taken should stand erect with the arms hanging straight at the sides. Snug measurements should be taken rather than tight or loose ones. A good quality tape that is sturdy should be used. It should not stretch nor should it be stiff. It should be pliable. The metal end should be used for vertical measurements and the other end for horizontal and circumference measurements. The tape should be held parallel to the floor for the horizontal measurements and perpendicular to the floor for the vertical measurements. To take measurements, upper body measurements. First one is high bust measurement. Measure around the back and chest just above the bust, keeping the tape parallel to floor across back. Bust. Measure around the fullest part of the bust. Center front body's length. Measure center front from base of neck to waistline tape. Length from center back neck to tip of the bust. Measure from tip of bust around neck to tip of other bust and divide the measurement into half. Length from center back neck over bust to waistline. Measure from waistline over tip of bust around neck over the bust to the waistline. Center back body's length. Measure center back from base of neck to waistline tape. Back shoulder width. 4 inches below base of the neck at the center back. Measure distance from armhole to armhole keeping tape parallel to the floor and arms relaxed at sides. Shoulder length, neck to arm socket. Measure shoulder length from base of the neck to arm socket. Upper arm circumference, with arm bent and fist clenched, measure around fullest part of the upper arm. Arm length, shoulder to elbow. With arm bent, measure from arm socket, that is end of the shoulder, to the point of elbow. Arm length, shoulder to wrist. With arm bent, measure from arm socket over elbow to wrist bone. Wrist circumference, measure around wrist below the wrist bone. Hand circumference, touch thumb to little finger, then measure at the position of greatest circumference. Lower body measurements, these include waistline, measure waist circumference, allow enough ease for comfort in wearing finished garment. High hip, measure high hip circumference 3 inches below waistline tape. Keep tape parallel to the floor. Hip at fullest part, measure fullest part of hip, keeping tape parallel to floor about 7 inches down the waist, and mark this point midway between side and center front. Waist to fullest part of hip, measure from waistline tape to hip as determined in step 16. Thigh, slip tape line down to largest measure of thighs, keeping tape parallel to the floor. Waist to thigh, measure a distance from waist to thigh as mentioned in step 18. Skirt length, measure from waist to floor at center front, center back, right side and left side. Subtract the number of inches skirt is to be worn from the floor. Add hem allowances as needed. The next one is pant length. Measure from waistline along side seam to desired length for pants. Leg circumference, measure the fullest part of thigh, bent knee, calf and instep. Crotch depth, sit erectly on a hard flat surface, measure along curve on side of the body from waistline tape to flat surface. Crotch length, measure total crotch length from front waistline between legs to back waistline. So after discussing all the important aspects of pattern making, principles of pattern making, that is we have drafting, flat pattern making, draping, and at the last we discussed about body measurements, different types of body measurements, that is horizontal, vertical. So we do assume that you can now perfectly and with confidence go for pattern making for your own garments. Thank you.